If you want to know what's happening with the global shipping industry, the Baltic Dry Index may be the most important indicator. Let's take a look. The Baltic Dry Index is sometimes referred to, but most investors aren't really sure what it is. We'll take a brief look into what the BDI is and why it's important. This can help you attain a further grasp into geopolitical tensions, economic issues, and give some insight into future events. It is renowned for its view as perhaps the most important indicator in the shipping industry. That's arguable, but it is still valuable data, and so we must certainly keep a close eye on it. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we are going to look at the Baltic Dry. I think this is one very important indicator. Whether or not it's the most or not doesn't matter, but I just simply want to cover exactly what it is, and then as time goes on, I'll be referencing this index because, quite frankly, it's very telling. The Baltic Dry Index is a shipping and trade index created by the London-based Baltic Exchange. It measures changes in the cost of transporting various raw materials such as coal and steel. Now remember that there are many different shipping indexes out there, but we are specifically focusing on the BDI today. Members of the exchange directly contact shipping brokers to assess price levels for a given shipping path, a product to transport, and time to delivery or speed. There's an in-depth calculation for how this comes to be on a daily basis. All I want to note here is that it's not created by one individual and it doesn't make up the price based on the value of a particular company or anything like that. Because dry bulk primarily consists of materials that function as raw material inputs to the production of immediate or finished goods such as concrete, electricity, steel, and food, the index is also seen as an efficient economic indicator of future economic growth and production. Think about the trade tensions that we have seen between China and the US as an example. This is one very good indicator to pay attention to, and you can see how they relate. This also goes for any type of issue that you would have with the global shipping industry. Think about problems that have happened between these shipping lines, between economic distress, such as a financial crisis. We see these generally as good leading indicators. The BDI is termed a leading economic indicator because it predicts future economic activity, and then they also mention the HARPEX, but I wanted to focus specifically on the BDI today. But that focuses on containers freight. It provides an insight on the transport of a much wider base of commercial goods than commodities alone. So you don't want to look at just one indicator in any way, shape, or form. You always want to have several indicators piling up so that you can get a wider view. That's why it's important to understand each and every one of these, at least the top ones, to give you a good idea of what's going on. I'm going to end the video there. I wanted to make it very clear as to exactly what this is, just give a few points just to educate everybody, because it's often referred to in the media when they're talking about the shipping industry and they're looking at an index, but I don't think people really understand what it is. That's really all you need to know. If you found the video informative, please give me a thumbs up. When you give me a thumbs up, you are supporting this channel. And if you want to know more about the financial industry, these two books have everything that you need. You can check them out at the link in the description. And if you want to know so many details, in my free e-course, I have hours and hours of content like this video here. So you can check out the link that's on the page here. Click that video and it'll start the playlist and you will be able to get that download, and I'll see you there.